Ericka, you know, it's incredible that we don't realize that there's such an interest in our in the American coastline. I mean, we have overdevelopment. Now we're faced with global warming. Just the human natural processes are basically destroying all of that coastline. And now your story is that what's left of it, they now want to take away from the public access. Is that basically the 10,000 foot of that?
Well, what we're seeing with the sea level rises, you know, everybody's trying to do these dredge and fill projects, and what's happening is a lot of these projects are basically taking away the resources that people go to those beaches for, especially here in Florida. You know, everything from surfing, diving, snorkeling.
But it's not just it's not just a Florida story, Ericka, is it? I mean, you've got 180 million people visit the beach for recreation. What is it? Almost a $110 billion industry for tourism all over the United States. But you have this influx of people. What is it? About 160 million people moving to try to live on a coastline. And so it's disappearing. I mean, before our eyes, I mean, the story in Florida has the same application in California, Texas, Louisiana, Alabama. Doesn't make any difference. The same plan is playing itself out, whether it's developers taking the coastline or the natural environment taking the coastline.
Yep. That's definitely what we're seeing. We're seeing, you know, everybody's moving straight on top of that first line of protection, your dune line, and it's definitely limiting the ability for even state residents, as well as visitors, to be able to get to the beach these days.
Let's use Florida as an example. I mean, Florida seems like the perfect example of, you know, what's going wrong here. I followed a story down in Palm Beach where they wanted to dredge offshore, bring in 700,000 cubic yards of sand. In the process, they destroy an entire reef, a hard bottom reef. They kill marine life. They destabilize the entire area and use of the area. But it's done because you have the Palm Beach Council that sits there without any real thought about what they're doing. They want to please the developer, number one. Developers want more beach. Number two, they want to make homeowners happy with the idea that their council's doing something for them because their beach has been, you know, blown away in a natural course of a hurricane. And it sounds like there's no thought that goes into this. I mean, I think that you know the Palm Beach case. So what are all the bad sides that come from something like the Palm Beach case? Because that same case, that same story can be told 1,000 times all over the coastline of America.
Right. Basically, with this particular case and how it applies everywhere else is, you know, coastal engineers use the same cost-benefit ratios and engineering modeling, and it's almost like a copy, cut, and paste, if you will. They just plug in new numbers, and they try to send these permits on their way. And in this particular
Well, first of all, let me stop you right here. Cost-benefit ratio is a scam. I mean, in the truest sense, it is a scam. We see cost-benefit ratio that applies whether, you know, you've got a pharmaceutical company that's trying to figure out how many people can we kill to where it's still beneficial. You see that with any kind of product, whether it's a safety product, whatever the product is, that cost-benefit analysis has been made part of our American culture to the point that it's killing us. And it's killing us right here, this cost-benefit analysis, isn't it? I mean, the benefit is we ought to have a quality of life down in Palm Beach or anywhere along the coast, and we ought to think about people first.
Or our resources. You know, all the other reasons why we have, you know, that drive our economies here. You know, the recreational industry, whether it's, you know, surfing, diving, fishing, I mean, is in the billions of dollars just for Palm Beach County alone here in Florida.
Yeah.
And there was a total lack of valuation for those resources in when they were trying to figure out this whole permit process.
Okay, but just people listening to this program, let's bring this down to reality. You've got some council people. They're not scientists. They're, you know, most of the time, if you're in Palm Beach, they probably come from a fairly affluent background. They probably relate to the developer much more than they relate to the surfer or the person who just says, look, I want to be able to take my family to the beach. Okay, this is a vacation destination area. I'd love to be able to take my family to the last 2 miles of beach that's available down there, right? Okay?
Right.
So where does the council, I mean, it's not just Palm Beach. You can go all over the country. These council, whether the city council, county council, whatever the hell it is, they're always going to line up on side of the establishment. And the problem is, and I bet it happened down there, is you don't have enough people turning out saying, look, I don't care whether you're trying to look out for the developer. I don't care whether you're trying to look out for the homeowner who has a $4 or $5 million house on the beach. You have to look out for the best interest of everybody. Most of the time, that does not take place, Ericka. Now, your group, Surfrider Foundation, you're trying to change all that, aren't you?
Yes. It's been a long road from going all the way from Long Beach, New York, Rhode Island, Jersey, all the different chapters for the Surfrider Foundation have been engaged at one point or another on challenging the direction of these beach fill projects.
The first thing people have to do is show up, isn't it? I mean, they need to.
Yeah.
You can't have a meeting where you have 20 developers, you have 50 homeowners that own homes that are worth $5-6 million, and not have anybody that says, look, this is a public trust in a sense. The public owns these last 5 miles, and I want to be able to take my child to be able to swim in the Atlantic Ocean or the Gulf of Mexico. I want them to be able to understand what it means to have a beach life. But they don't show up, do they? I mean, you don't have people show up and say, you shouldn't dredge 700,000 cubic yards of sand off of a natural reef and put it on a beach. They don't show up. I mean, I live in Pensacola, Florida. We saw the same thing happen here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, it's tough because a lot of times people don't know what to say, other than this doesn't seem right, and that's a lot of what the case was, is putting the science behind those rational thoughts of this doesn't make sense. How do we get around this? How do we challenge this? What we were lucky is we did have folks going to the adjacent community that was going to be impacted by this project, and there we had over 500 people turn out in opposition to the project.
Okay, but turnout is the first step, isn't it?
Yes, very much so.
Now, Surfrider Foundation, it's not just what you're doing down in Palm Beach, it's what you're doing all over the country right now, right?
Correct. We have over 60 chapters nationwide. Got about 70,000 members. There are 11 chapters here in Florida, but you can bet there's at least one in every coastal state.
Okay, you're gonna have a lot of people listen to this program that say it's something I want to be involved with. How do they? You have a website?
Yeah, the easiest thing to do is just go to www.surfrider.org.
Okay. So, to bring this thing in for landing, there are a lot of issues. It's global warming's one of the issues, overdevelopment by developers who just care about, in cost-benefit analysis, it's all about money to them. You've got human natural process of human intervention, too many people on the coast. 160 million people moved to the coast just in the last, since 1980, you had about a 33 million person increase moving to the coast. And it seems like they're moving to the coast at the wrong time. And so it seems to me like you have bigger problems than you had 10 years ago as far as trying to preserve the coast, don't you?
Oh, definitely. And especially now with our increased storm, activity on top of that, people just don't realize what they're getting into when they buy that home on the dune. They really don't.
Ericka, good luck with this project, Surfrider Foundation Beach Access Initiative. That's taking place in Florida, but it needs to take place all over this country right now, and sounds like y'all are the only people paying attention to it in any serious way.